It was only a one-yard run in the last minute of play. Just 1 yard, 36 inches, by itself not much, but coupled with what had happened in the previous 59 minutes, it shook the entire state of Nebraska and sent tremors all the way to Miami.
The Barry Switzer Show. The Barry Switzer Show is brought to you by the people of Kerr-McGee Corporation, putting natural resources to work for you. Here's Barry with Howard Neumann.
This past weekend in Lincoln, Nebraska, the Oklahoma Sooners did something a lot of people didn't think we could do: defeat Nebraska and win or share our ninth consecutive Big 8 Conference Championship. One of the greatest victories we've ever had, Howard.
Sure was, Barry, and on this Thanksgiving night, we're thankful for a lot of things. Not just for the victory, but all thankful for, in the past 8 years, we've only been in the valley 9 times under your head coaching career, and we've been to that mountaintop 81 times now. 81 victories and only 9 losses. That really is.
What do you think about that, JC?
Hey, I want to say part of it.
Okay, I want to say more than that. You know what we're really thankful for? It's something to care about, but most important, a bunch of coaches and a bunch of players that are typified by this guy right here, JC Watts.
You're exactly right, Howard, and J.C. and I have joked all week long about the mail we received when we were 2-2, Howard. A few of the fold had fallen to the wayside. You know, one thing we joke about, a lot of people make as much noise getting on the wagon as they do getting off the wagon sometimes. And we wanted to bring some of our letters on the show tonight and read a few of them. Some people had even signed their names to them. But J.C. and I decided we got a little more class than that. And they know who they are.
Okay.
And we get last laugh anyway, don't we, Junior?
That's right. We got the last laugh.
Let's all three of us sit here and, along with the audience, just relive what it was like last Saturday up in Lincoln, Nebraska.
The two Big Reds meet again. But never before had Switzer's Big Red been given such a small chance of winning. Never before had the Big Red of the North been given such a big vote of confidence by the experts.
To call the toss. They need the visitors. Now, Captain Rozier is going to call the toss. It's a Big 8 flipping coin, tails and heads. Now, it's windy, but I'm going to throw it up in the air. If I don't catch it, I'm going to throw it up again. You call it the air, please. All right? Heads. All right, did you understand that he called heads, Nebraska? And it's tails. So Nebraska wins the toss. You may kick or receive or defend either goal.
Nebraska elected to score first. Oklahoma was put in the hole early by the Cornhuskers' premier runner, Jarvis Redwine. Everything was happening as predicted. It wasn't long after Redwine's touchdown that a Nebraska field goal put the Sooners behind 10-0. But Oklahoma had been behind before against Nebraska, and they had come back. Today would be no different. Barry and his coaches discussed how to beat the number one defense in the country. Their solution? Use what many feel is the number one offense. J.C. Watts demonstrated his mastery of the triple option against a defense that knew it was coming and couldn't stop it. Oklahoma's offense had taken the lead away from Nebraska, but now it was time for a swarming Sooner defense to stop the nation's most productive offense. Oklahoma's defense had no business stopping the Cornhuskers like this, especially on fourth down and two at the 7-yard line. There wouldn't be much time for OU's defenders to bask in the glory of a goal line stand. Nebraska doesn't quit. They come back. The Sooners were down. Late in the game, Nebraska had taken the lead they had been predicted to have far earlier. The Cornhuskers seemed to be little more than 3 minutes away from Miami. It was time for Barry to work his magic over Nebraska. It didn't start out looking magical. But the magic was still there. It came as it has so often before. A perfect wishbone. The Sooners had pushed Nebraska back up against the city limits of El Paso. But J.C. Watts and Bobby Grayson knew that wasn't enough. Happiness, yes. Victory, not yet. Oklahoma-Nebraska tradition is built on tension, and it was still mounting. Nebraska fought to keep its dream alive. Nebraska was hoping, Oklahoma was expecting the magic to work. It did. Nebraska had time for one last attempt, one last desperate attempt. Oklahoma took the ball, the victory, the glory away from Nebraska once again. The Sooners just don't pay much attention to odds.
Let's go. Okay. Hey, listen up. I want to say something. Hey, I want to say something, man. We got a game next week. We got to back up everything we said. And I want to know one thing. Are there any good Mexican restaurants in Miami?
Boy, there haven't been many moments like that. There have been some.
That's what I was thinking, Howard. There's been, life holds very few moments like that.
That's right. And J.C., while you were watching that, your leg went up there once. You were twisting, you were turning, you were playing every play right over again.
Oh, boy, I tell you what, it was great. And, boy, those films put chills up and down your back, I assure you.
A lifetime to remember. 60 minutes to play, but a lifetime to remember, Howard. Sure,
I tell you, a weekend at Nebraska. I guess Nebraskans feel like that when they come to Norman, but up there in Lincoln, it starts when you get there, and you can feel it all over. But I guess it's because the whole state centers on one school. It's undivided. It's the University of Nebraska. But something happened up there, Barry, on Friday night that I think you ought to share with the folks, because it's priceless.
I think most of our fans realize that that we were playing, actually, we accepted the Sun Bowl bid after the Missouri ball game. And it was extended. We didn't have an opportunity to the Fiesta Bowl, as some people might have indicated we had, the Nebraska camp. Bob Devaney was outspoken in the fact that he said that the Barry Switzer had cost the Big 8 Conference thousands of dollars by accepting the Sun Bowl bid, a tie-up with Nebraska-Oklahoma game, Orange or Sun Bowl. And, of course, I made this statement on my television show, the playback show, a week ago Sunday after we defeated Missouri. I said, it's the annual shootout now for the Orange Bowl and the Sun Bowl, and I said, you know, really, I guess we're playing for stone crabs or tacos. And, and of course, this ran big in the Lincoln papers and the Nebraska papers and Nebraska papers. And so when I arrived on Friday night, a lot of people were, there were signs up, we were going to send Switzer to eat Mexican dinners in El Paso and hope he likes tamales and all this. And so Bob Devaney was at the press party. And Bob, of course, is a heck of a great guy, you know, and he comes up to me and we visit about, you know, the Sun Bowl and who's going to eat tamales and who's going to get to go eat seafood and all this. And it's all in good fun. Well, I happened to have to do a live, for Channel 4, mm-hmm. I had to do a live show with Ron Thulin. And so we go out to the Lincoln television station and we get in our little cubby hole and we shoot back live at 10:15 to Oklahoma City. And when we get through, I walk out and I look at the main studio like this one. I see it all lit up and I say, well, what's going on here? And they say, well, Bob Devaney is going to do his television prediction show tonight, the 30-minute show. He's going to do it live. I said, is that right? And he said, yeah. And I said, how about doing me a favor? There's a Taco Bell down the street here. Go down there and buy two tacos for me. I go up to the host, Dick Janna. I say, Dick, this is what I want to do. Dick says, hey, well, we love it. He says, don't tell Bob now. And he said, I won't. And says, the audience will love it. So I get behind the stage, and as you see this film, which we're going to show in a few minutes, it will look like it's a written script, as you know, Harry, because you've seen it. It looks like it was written, because Bob gives me the great key. He couldn't have written it better. He doesn't know I'm behind his set, and all of a sudden he says, bingo, the right thing for me to enter on stage, and we'll get to see it here, exactly what happened.
Okay.
Ray Hong has brought this pineapple. We hope to give it to Barry Switzer. In case Barry didn't get to go to the Orange Bowl, he could eat the pineapple instead of the tamales that they served down there in El Paso.
Well, Ray,
Barry, that was the thing.
Thanks very much for being here. I guess we pulled out all... Whoa, wait a minute here. I guess
hey,
he's
Bob?
In person here.
Barry. Hey, I appreciate the pineapple, but I've got a couple of tacos for you, Bob.
Oh, God. Hey, one of the greatest coaches in the country, and it's great to be here with us here.
Thank you, Bob.
Thank you.
I want to tell you
and
something.
I'll tell you, wherever we go, we're well fed.
You didn't know I was back here, did you?
Barry, I'll tell you, I've never for sure where you've been, but I've
I want to tell you something. You have too, and I want to tell you, America respects Bob Devaney. You're one of the greatest coaches this game's ever had.
Barry, you've done the same thing for this game of football. It's going to be a great game tomorrow.
they missed the part, which was great. He stood there. I walked off the set, and Lee Allen Smith and a bunch of us are standing there watching him. He stood there with that sack of tacos for, I guess, the entire show. And later on in the show, he looks down and says, God, I hope I don't have to eat these things. I thought it was great. Couldn't have been written better.
No, it couldn't have. And he really is. Bob Devaney is a great guy.
Oh, yeah, super guy.
Oh, and he was a coach who was really cooperative with us.
Great, and really, I meant that. Bob Devaney is one of the great football coaches in intercollegiate football has ever had.
That's right. Another thing we're thankful for in this Thanksgiving is Mr. Dean McGee and the people of Kerr-McGee for having the faith in the show over these many, many years to sponsor it. And this year we've been showing you interesting insights into the University of Oklahoma, and here's Bill Teague to show you another one. Kerr-McGee began saluting the academic excellence at the University of Oklahoma with a visit with Dr. William S. Banowski, president of the university. Today, we are pleased to have with us Dr. E.T. Dunlap, chancellor, Oklahoma State System of Higher Education. Dr. Dunlap, would you comment upon the relationship between the state system and the University of Oklahoma?
Oklahoma has 27 colleges and universities that compose our higher education system, and the University of Oklahoma is the oldest of the 27, and it has a function that includes undergraduate education and graduate education and research through the doctoral level.
What do you perceive as the main strengths of the University of Oklahoma?
Oklahoma's faculty, as well as its leadership, are two main strengths of the university, and those are qualities that are essential if an institution is dynamic and responsive to the changing needs as new knowledge occurs.
Dr. Dunlap, you speak with a viewpoint of 30 years of work in higher education. What does it take for the University of Oklahoma to be more useful in the future?
Well, whereas in the last two decades we have concentrated on expansion to accommodate an increasing number of students, in the 10 years ahead, we will, as enrollments level off, we will begin to devote more time and more effort and more of our resources to improving the quality of education. At the University of Oklahoma, as example, we've recently authorized a new college to be known as the College of Geosciences, which will be made up of parts of other colleges, including geology and certain petroleum and other related educational activities that pertain to energy and energy-based type education. Also, the Regents, our board has authorized a $30 million structure with about two-thirds of the money, hopefully, to come from the private source and about $10 million to come from state dollars to build an energy center, which we hope will be preeminent for education of that type throughout the nation.
Dr. Dunlap, I suppose the teacher is still the key to academic excellence.
Yes, there's no institution, there's no program of education any better than the quality of the person in charge of the classroom.
Thank you very much, Dr. Dunlap, for your perspective on the University of Oklahoma and the future as it relates to academic excellence.
Thank you, sir. Good to be with you.
J.C., I know that not too many highs like last Saturday against Nebraska, but the season isn't over. What about Saturday?
That's true. Oklahoma State's got a good football team, and, well, we don't want to let down now. We're coming off an emotional high against Nebraska, and OSU could spoil this thing for us. So I think the guys realize what's at stake, and I think we'll go out and we'll play well.
Very frankly, I've heard that before, and sometimes yet against a Kansas State or someone like that, I've sensed a letdown.
That's true, but I think the guys have, in the past, in the last couple of weeks, we've had this thing about Orange Bowl saying we're going to have to win both ball games, and we went unbeaten Nebraska, and I think this is the second step to making it to the Orange Bowl. And I think everybody's prepared for the ball game. We practiced pretty good this week, and we're looking forward to it.
Besides that, Bob Devaney hasn't ate the tacos yet. We've got to make him eat the tacos. You know, well, that'd be the worst thing that happened is OSU could beat us and share the conference championship and allow them to go to the Orange Bowl. And that would upset me because it's really not fair what the Orange Bowl has done to us. You know, that's in 1978, true. We were undefeated and we were ranked the number one team in the nation when we went to Lincoln, Nebraska. And we lost up there. And it looked like we would have a 10-1 season. There's no way we could either have an undefeated or a 10-1 season. But yet they said that they would take the winner of our ball game, and Nebraska had Missouri to play yet. And what happened is Missouri did beat Nebraska. Mm-hmm. But the Orange Bowl already said they would take them. Now this year comes along, and they said we had to win them all for us to get there. They didn't quite treat us the same way as they did Nebraska. They made it a little tougher on us.
You're going to win them all.
We're going to win them all.
J.C., I remember once when you were backing up Thomas Lott, he came off and you and he were talking. I think you'd played a few times. And I remember one of the things he said on the sidelines. He says, J.C., when you go into that line, you just hold the ball, make them come to you, and make them respect you. And I was thinking last Saturday of that word respect and how much respect you've gained, not just with the way you play, but with the way you've conducted yourself. Because there are not too many people twice your age, three times your age, who could be subjected to the kind of criticism sometimes you've had, just thrown at you, unwarranted, but criticism, and just keep performing at your best.
Well, the thing about that, Howard, is the important thing that I remember was my teammates and my coaches. They didn't quit believing in me, and that was important to me, and they stuck behind me. And I tell you what, there was a time you had to have shoulders of steel, and I think I had that, and I came through, and you know, pretty good.
No, I think he came through pretty good. He's been coming through pretty good for you.
2 years quarterback, 2 years Big 8 Conference Championship.
Yeah, J.C., as you look ahead, what do you want to accomplish in life?
Well, I don't know, Howard. It's a lot of things I want to do, and it's a lot of things I've got planned for the future. But right now, I don't know what I want to do. I've got a lot of avenues to take, but I have no idea. But I guess I'm fortunate, though, a 23-year-old guy just getting out of college. Got a lot of avenues to take. You know, a lot of guys, they're searching for something, but it's there for me. It's just a matter of, you know, just taking one and sticking with it.
What about the team now for the rest of the season? The unity is there. The winning momentum is there, whatever momentum is. But just how does the team feel about this season?
I think everybody has to be satisfied with what we've accomplished. This season we started out slow. We had a 2-2 record, and a lot of people had given up on us. The press had, you know, said that Oklahoma wouldn't compete for the Big 8 title this year. And after the Texas game, I think we did some soul searching, and we found ourselves. And each and every week we started to become the team that we wanted to be. And last week we went up to Nebraska and beat Nebraska in Lincoln. And I think that's evident of the type of the commitment that we made to ourselves after the Texas game. And boy, it's not a finer way to end a career, you know, beating Nebraska and Lincoln.
Yeah, even a better way is to beat OSU and then beat
right,
Florida State in that Orange Bowl.
Bowl.
Yeah. incidentally, I talk about the press. This is a magazine.
Huh? Who's that good-looking guy?
Oh, there's a good-looking guy on the cover. Barry, what's his name, is on the cover of Oklahoma Sooner magazine. This is a great magazine. You ought to subscribe. It comes out every week during football season and then every month the rest of the year, and it's
make a great Christmas gift, Howard.
Okay, it would.
It would.
They
cover recruiting
gift.
Everything, and they have a great picture in there every week. You know, it's 20 issues, and it comes out monthly and weekly during football season. That's the hit right there. Remember, Scotty Hill hit against Tony Dorsett in 1975. It's a good magazine, great pictures, and they do a super job of writing, covering Sooners football.
Really do. Speaking of great, here's another great Sooner moment.
Been some great leaders and great players played here. Accomplished is about as much as you can expect. 3 Big 8 championships. Lose one game in their career. Opportunity today to win a national championship.
November 30th, 1974. The annual Bedlam Battle of Football. OU against OSU. There were plenty of offensive highlights. The Sooners scored 44 points. But the play that will be remembered longest came from Joe Washington, who went through the Cowboy defense like smoke through a keyhole. Joe Washington's 57-yard touchdown run, capping off a national championship year. A great Sooner moment.
Barry, I want to congratulate you on being named by UPI as Big 8 Coach of the Year.
Remember, we used to not like UPI. It was AP we loved.
Yeah, I know.
Back when we were on probation, they wouldn't rank us. Yeah, UPI called the other day and said that that they had selected me Big 8 Coach of the Year. But, of course, you know, our players and assistant coaches are the ones that make those things happen. They're the ones that prepare our football players to play and do a super job, and they're the ones that really deserve the recognition.
Barry, this is the last show in our regular season. What have you got to say? I've always asked you questions. Do you think of anything you'd like to say?
Oh, Howard, I think it, you know, we've won in 8 years that I've been head football coach. We've won 81 games and lost 9 and tied 2, which is our program is the best in college football in winning percentage. And we've had a lot of great players come through our program. We've had a lot of great seasons, great teams. Everyone's comparing one team to the other. Saturday's win, probably, when I reflect now, is probably the most satisfying of the fact that we faced so much adversity, so many injuries this year, and we stumbled to a 2-2 start. And as JC said a minute ago, a lot of people didn't think we would be where we are today. We were criticized, maligned in many ways. And so to me, this season is certainly more satisfying than a 1974 or 75 when I knew we had great players and were a national championship caliber for this team to come as far as it has.
Well, all I have to say is it's just been a pleasure to be associated and know a fellow like J.C. Watts. I remember your senior year of high school, standing visiting with you on the sideline, J.C., right, and said, hey, you're going to be out there someday doing their thing. And boy, you really has. Barry, thank you for the privilege of doing the show with you this year. And
thank
good
you.
Luck against OSU and in the Orange Bowl.
Thank you, Howard.
Thank you very much for watching. You've been a very fine audience. We thank you for your questions and thank you for your loyalty. On behalf of the folks at Kerr-McGee Corporation, we hope you've had a very fine Thanksgiving and have a happy holiday season ahead. Good night.
Clothes for Barry and Howard come from Harold's, Norman, Oklahoma City, and Tulsa. Furnishings provided by Landsaws of Norman. Ground transportation for the Barry Switzer Show crew furnished by Smokey Davidson Dodge, Edmond.